Hi, I'm Mike from 1A Auto. We're dedicated to delivering quality auto parts, expert customer service, fast and free shipping, all backed by our 100% satisfaction guarantee. So visit us at 1AAuto.com, your trusted source for quality auto parts.
In this video, we're going to be working with our 2001 Ford Ranger. We're going to show you how to remove and replace your front sway bar links. If you like this video, please click subscribe. We have a ton more information on this truck as well as many other makes and models. And if you need these parts for your vehicle, you can follow the link down in the description over to 1AAuto.com. Here are the items you'll need for this repair. There are a few ways to remove the sway bar link on your vehicle. You can do it on the ground with the wheels on, with the vehicle raised and supported and the wheels on, or with the vehicle raised and supported and the wheels off. The latter is my favorite method just because it gives you a lot more room to work with and makes it easier to deal with if something is stuck or being difficult to remove. Using a taped flat blade screwdriver, locate the relief cuts in the hubcap. Stick the screwdriver in and pry out to release it from the wheel. This particular truck has a wheel lock on it, so we'll need the wheel lock key in order to remove it. Otherwise, the rest of the nuts come off with a 19 millimeter socket and breaker bar. Simply crack them loose for now. Then raise and support your vehicle and remove the lug nuts the rest of the way. Remove the wheel from the vehicle. To remove the sway bar link, there's a long bolt that runs all the way through this style link. We'll put the appropriate size wrench on the top. Ours is a 16, yours may be different. Rotate it to brace it against the frame because these tend to get pretty rusty and tough to remove. With our wrench braced against the frame, we'll get the appropriate socket, in this case an 18 and a breaker bar. Put it on the bottom nut, which is under the control arm. It's very likely that yours is just going to break like ours did. Another method you can try is getting a pair of locking pliers onto the sleeve, bracing it against the control arm or whatever you can get them against, and trying to twist off the bolt at the top. Repeat the steps to either break or remove the bolt on the opposite side. Now we can move our sway bar up and out of the control arms and give us a little more room to work. Now that we've got some room to work, we've clamped onto the rubber bushing at the bottom. I'm going to see if you can work that off either by pulling on it or by twisting. There's 16 on the top. There's one more part off. We'll repeat this step with the sleeves. And again with the long sleeve. Now our washer, sleeve, and the lower bushing have all come off together. If yours don't, you can repeat the process until you get to the top bushing and washer, and you're able to remove your link. We'll now repeat these steps on the opposite side. Here we have our old sway bar link that we removed from our vehicle and our new part from 1AAuto.com. As you can see, these parts are exactly the same, although ours did break in quite a few places on the way off. That's very common on these because it's a long bolt that goes through a metal sleeve. So these fill with water and debris and seize onto the bolt. They can be a real pain to get out. Fortunately, reassembly is pretty straightforward. We have the long bolt, which holds everything together. When it's installed, we'll have our washer and a bushing. This will drop through our sway bar. We'll have a bushing and then a washer on the bottom side of our sway bar. The sleeve to properly space everything and keep it at the right height. Another washer and bushing, followed by our lower control arm, which will then pinch together with a bushing, washer, and the new nut. Now, it's usually a good idea when assembling the new one to go ahead and put some kind of anti-seize grease or lubricant on here to keep this from freezing up and making it difficult to remove again in the future. Having a bad sway bar link can cause a popping noise going over bumps and make you feel a little bit more body roll when taking hard corners or at high speed. Fortunately, they're easy to replace, and this replacement part from 1A Auto is going to go in direct fit, just like your original equipment. Get your vehicle handling right with a nice quiet suspension and fix you up right. We'll take a moment to coat about half of our bolt for right now in an anti-seize grease or lubricant. We'll start by installing our washer with the concave side facing down. We'll install our first bushing on there. This tapered end will face down into the sway bar. It goes down through the top, at which point we'll apply a little more grease, followed by a bushing with that tapered end facing up into the bottom of the sway bar, and a washer with the concave side facing up to the bottom of the bushing. We'll apply some more grease, followed by our sleeve. More grease, a washer with the concave side facing down, and a bushing with the tapered end facing down into the control arm. We'll place that down into our control arm. We're not going to put the bottom in yet because we always replace sway bar links in a pair, and it's going to make installing the other side a lot easier. We'll follow this same procedure to install the other side and then finish up with our bushings, washers, and a nut. Now, once we've got everything put together, we'll install the tapered side of our bushing up. We'll have to pry down on our sway bar a little to compress those bushings some and give us some slack to get the thread started. The 16 millimeter socket and ratchet on the top and an 18 millimeter wrench, or in this case, I'm using a breaker bar for a little more leverage. Go ahead and start tightening down your sway bar link until you've compressed the bushings nice and tight. We'll just get them down tight until they've compressed the bushings. They sit in there nice and tight without really crushing or cracking any of these bushings. Tighten down the other side the same way. Reinstall the wheel and tire. And start your lug nuts by hand. Nuts to 100 foot-pounds in a cross pattern. Reinstall your center cap and you're good to go.
Thanks for watching. Visit us at 1AAuto.com for quality auto parts, fast and free shipping, and the best customer service in the industry.